Everyone struggles when they first start reading tarot cards. Everyone. There are 78 different tarot cards, and each card can be interpreted in multiple ways. Trying to memorize the meanings is frustrating. It takes too long, and it doesn't even work anyway. So instead, I'm going to show you a way that you can cheat your way to understanding by learning the patterns and symbols behind the cards. I'm Angie from The Simple Tarot, and I am excited about this topic today because I struggled with learning the tarot card meanings for way too long, trying to memorize them one by one. That is not the best way to learn them, so in this video, I'm going to show you exactly how I finally mastered tarot card meanings quickly and actually kind of enjoyably. But first, if you're new here and you want to learn all of my tarot tips, tricks, and sneaky little tools, hit the subscribe button and then click that little bell that pops up so you can stay in the loop when there's new tarot videos for you. It is easier to understand and remember the card meanings when you know the underlying patterns and symbols. There are many symbols that will help you learn the major arcana cards, but first we're going to start with the minor arcana, specifically the four elements of air, earth, fire, and water, and the four suits of the cups, pentacles, swords, and the wands. When you understand the suits and the elements, you can combine them with the card numbers or the people cards to get the card's meaning. For example, the King of Wands is a passionate master of power and creativity. So the King cards always mean a person who is an active master of his or her domain when they represent a person. The Wands cards always represent passion, creativity, and personality. And the fire element always represents intensity and bolsters the Wands cards. So therefore, the King of Wands becomes an intense, passionate master of power and creativity. So we can do this for all of the cards, which will start to give us a common language, pattern, logic, and format for their meanings. So let's get started with the cups cards. Cups are used when we toast in celebration, connect over meals, and drown our sorrows. The cards of the cup suit represent your relationships and your emotional connections. They have to do with love, friendship, connection, and affairs of the heart. A person ruled by the cups or the water element will be creative, empathetic, nurturing, intuitive, and caring. But if this energy is taken too far, it will become needy, overly sensitive, easily hurt, and demanding of attention and emotional validation. The water element is connected with the cups suit. You'll often find the water on the cups cards. It is also commonly shown on the cards with a strong emotional element, such as the Six of Swords or the Three of Swords, where it's shown as rain. Water is also found on the Temperance card and the Star, where it is combined with Earth to represent harmony. Pentacles look like coins. The cards of the Pentacles suit represent the physical world, including money, property, worldly possessions, your home, a career, or your physical body. A person ruled by the pentacles or by the earth element will be hardworking, practical, loyal, and stable. If this energy is taken too far, it can become shallow, petty, dull, boring, or miserly. People who are ruled by the pentacles make great project managers, but they often lose track of the forest because they are too busy counting and cataloging the trees, or each leaf on the trees, even. I should know, I'm one of them. The earth element is connected to the suit of pentacles. In tarot, it is often depicted as an abundant garden, trees, or a forest. It is often shown on cards with a strong practical or physical element, such as the magician or the empress. The sword suit represents the intellect, including logical thought, intellectual pursuits, and communication. A sword can cut both ways, and many of the cards in the sword suit are tough lessons to learn. The swords will cut through confusion, lies, and limiting beliefs. They can be used to attack, and they will allow you to defend your most cherished ideals. A person ruled by the swords or by the air element will be dynamic, witty, intelligent, and action-oriented. But if this energy is taken too far, it can become cold-hearted, distant, or cruel. They are excellent at solving problems and making plans, but their sharp tongue and cutting words can ruin relationships quickly. The air element connected with the sword suit. In tarot, it is often depicted by birds in flight, moving clouds, butterflies, or other beings and animals with wings. It is also sometimes shown on cards with a strong intellectual or logical element, such as the Eight of Wands, the Four of Cups, the Justice card, and the Emperor. The Wands cards represent the burning passions of your personality and spirit. These cards are about creativity, inspiration, ambition, dreams, and goals. A person ruled by the Wands or by the fire element will be driven, passionate, optimistic, energetic, and creative. But if this energy is taken too far, it can become self-centered, overly dramatic, rash, or immature. While they may be extremely charismatic and energetic, they sometimes hog the limelight and let their tempers blaze into a roaring inferno. The fire element is connected with the Wands suit. In tarot, it is often depicted by a desert or a blazing sun. It is often shown on cards with a strong element of energy or passion, such as the Four Aces, the Chariot, and the Sun card. All right, so that's the four basic suits of the tarot and their corresponding elements. A basic understanding of these patterns and symbols will go a long way in helping you to understand your tarot cards. If this video was helpful or useful in any way, please hit that like button right now and let me know. And if you have any questions at all, leave a comment down below and I'll do my best to sort you out. That's why I'm here.